In our previous episode, we discussed on the fundamentals of composting and the types of composting, like the aerobic and the anaerobic methods of composting. In today's episode, we'll discuss on the materials that can be used and those to be avoided in composting, plus the ideal carbon-nitrogen ratio and the green-to-brown ratio. Coming up. Composting is a controlled and accelerated rotting down of organic material into nutrient-rich compost. Aerobic composting uses the natural process of rotting and decay by microorganisms in the presence of oxygen and produces heat, and hence it's sometimes called hot pile composting. Whereas anaerobic or Bokashi composting is the job done mainly by the microorganisms in the absence of air, which is more like a fermentation process. Aerobic composting requires four things: carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and water in just the right amount for proper composting. Out of these, we need to provide carbon and nitrogen in the proper ratio, what is known as the carbon-nitrogen ratio or the CN ratio. Things that are rich in carbon are called the browns, and those that are rich in nitrogen are known as the greens. To be correctly composted, a material needs to have the following two important characteristics. The waste material must be organic and biodegradable. Secondly, the waste material must contain things that are liked by microorganisms to feed on. So, what types of waste can we use in aerobic composting method? Firstly, let's start with what we should not put into our compost bin or compost heap. So, let's list out the don'ts first. That is, glass, metal, and plastics are obviously prohibited in both types of composting, that is aerobic and anaerobic. Secondly, oil, fat, meat, fish, or dairy products are avoided because of the tendency to attract insects like flies and even rodents. But these products are allowed in Bokashi composting. Well, thirdly, hard woody branches, stems, or roots, which take a very long time to decompose. Then fourthly, rubber bands, latex condoms, diapers, and other obvious stuff like metallic objects, like for example safety pins. Having looked at the things to be avoided, now let's look at the things that we can add, and there are literally thousands to choose from. Aerobic composting works best if these microorganisms are fed a mixture of carbon-rich materials known as the browns and the nitrogen-rich materials known as the greens in proper ratios. Let's list out the browns first. Browns are mostly dried woody materials which are high in carbon. Without the browns, your greens will decompose too quickly and turn into a smelly pile that's called putrefied pile. Here is the list of browns: dry fallen leaves, dried flowers, wood chips, twigs, straw, shredded paper, shredded cardboard or paper cartons, and also the toilet paper rolls. Then toilet paper, or used napkins or facial tissues, then coffee filters and tea bags, cotton, sawdust, pine needles, pencil shavings, dried grass clippings, peat moss, cocoa peat or coconut fibers, used paper plates, nutshells, wine corks, toothpicks, paper cupcakes, used matchsticks, wood ash or ashes from the fireplace, coal, and so on. Now let's list the greens. Greens are mostly wet materials like waste kitchen scraps, mostly the vegetable scraps, fruit scraps, fresh grass cuttings, animal manure but not your cat or dog poop, bird or poultry droppings, yes, and even feathers, fleshy plants and leaves, flowers, tea and coffee waste, eggshells, nail clippings, mind you, no nail polish, human and animal hair, and so on. Having said that, now let's look at the greens versus the browns ratio and the carbon nitrogen ratio. The right mixture of greens and browns, known commonly in the gardening world as the carbon to nitrogen ratio or the CN ratio, and it's important for proper composting. We want composting and not putrefaction or rotting. So what is the ideal CN ratio for aerobic composting? Most experts suggest a CN ratio of 25:30:1, which means 25 to 30 parts carbon-rich material to 1 part nitrogen-rich material. high carbon may result in too slow composting, whereas high nitrogen may result in foul-smelling putrefaction process. So, how to use the carbon-nitrogen ratio? Do not misinterpret this carbon-nitrogen ratio. This ratio describes the chemical composition of a material and does not mean that you need to add a volume of brown materials that is 30 times greater than the amount of green matter. Do not make this mistake. Here comes the green to brown ratio to our rescue. You have to understand this carefully. The ideal green to brown ratio is 2:1, but it can also be 1:1 for those that who are starting to compost. This means for one bowl of greens, you add one bowl of browns. Let me explain this. Every material has its own carbon-nitrogen ratio. Like for example, food scraps has a carbon-nitrogen ratio of 17:1, meaning 17 parts of carbon to 1 part nitrogen. And sawdust has a very high carbon-nitrogen ratio of 500:1. Hence, this calculation depends on what you want to add to your compost bin. And it gets more and more complicated. You can store this table shown on the screen for reference of the CN values of various materials. For ideal composting, do remember these two golden tips. A 2:1 ratio of greens to brown is your best bet when creating a batch pile. This will aid you in creating about 30:1 CN ratio, adequate enough to get a hot pile. A 1:1 ratio works well with the add as you go pile as well as for the batch pile and is safe for beginners. This will aid you in creating about a 50:1 CN ratio and adequate enough to get a warm pile. In our next episodes of this composting series, we'll demonstrate how to do aerobic and anaerobic or the Bokashi composting at home. Please like, share and comment below with your feedback and queries. Happy composting and happy gardening.